glad to have you with us in the studio. I'm Reese Davis, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. These two teams have won shootouts and endured slugfests and now find themselves in position to be a conference champion. The title game in Conference USA. What do you think of that? That does it for us here on the NCAA College Football Pregame Show. Enjoy the game. We'll see you at the half.
Someone will be crowned Conference USA champion. The question is, who will it be?
It's time for the coin toss now, presented by Coke Zero. Real Coke taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. Louisiana Tech is lined up to kick the ball off first, and we are ready to go. He's to the 20. He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line. So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. Has it to the senior. Good tackle there in space.
Marshall's got a guy that's in a running for a national award here, Herbie. And, you know, the best time to talk about awards really is after you win them. Right now, it's all speculation. He's just got to play the game.
Completes it across the middle. That's a great tackle at the 41. Stopped immediately. Now he's scrambling. Tackle around the 47-yard line. They'll get the first down.
He made the correct decision to tuck it and go.
Six-yard line. And that's their third first down of the drive.
The defense needs to figure out a way to stop them, or else they're going to have no problem putting points on the board.
Slings it. He's tackled at the 25-yard line.
It's a nice job here by the wide receiver of looking the ball in and keeping the chains moving. He was on the same page as his quarterback as they both saw the double outside linebacker blitz coming.
From the 25-yard line, first down. And he just gets rid of it. This is the eighth play of this drive. Throws complete, and he's hit right away. Stop at the 16-yard line. Smith picks up about 4 yards with a catch.
That makes it fourth and inches.
They'll call on the field goal unit here. Marshall is looking to go up by three. It's up, and it's good. Hall is lined up to kick this one off. He just drills this one. He's to the 20. Tackle made at the 28. The
The quarterback brings his troops out onto the field for the first drive of the game. Got a man complete, and he's hit hard.
That brings him second and goal.
Inside.
They'll bring him down at the 42.
That's a gain of 9 on the play. First down.
Hands off left, and they got him behind the line.
I don't think the play developed the way it was supposed to, and the net result is a loss.
From their own 39-yard line, it's second down. He might have a chance. Gains his way to midfield.
That's good for a gain of 11 yards. That'll bring up 32.
Let's go.
There he goes. Runs outside for a nice gain.
Let's go.
Brought down right around the 28-yard line.
Good job by the offensive line to pick up the linebacker on the blitz. That gave the quarterback enough time to find his man for a nice game.
Taken down right around the 6-yard line.
That makes it first and goal.
Nice run, and he's brought down. Touchdown, Bulldogs.
Great job of finding the space to run and just bursting in for six.
And he converts the extra point. A 9-play, 71-yard drive, and they get it in for 7.
Kirk, we saw this guy head to the locker room a little bit earlier. Good to see him back on the sideline, and it looks like he could be returning to the game.
Garrison has the ball set, and he looks ready to kick this one deep. And he's tackled at the 37-yard line. You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play. Tackle made at the 48-yard line. Shoved out of bounds at the 40.
Come on, go.
7-yard line.
That'll bring up second and three.
They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. Both offenses trying to find their rhythm in that first quarter. Low scoring and close right now. The Bulldogs lead 7-3. We can only hope the second quarter is as good as the first. Tight ball game, folks. They'll wrestle him down in the backfield. It's third down and 5 to go. Ball on the 9.
You don't own it. Check 93 to Mike. Red 2, green 9.
Just throws this one away.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
He gets it up, and it is good.
And you got to think they're pretty happy with holding him to a field goal right there.
The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. DeLoach from the 6. He's taken down at the 27.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions.
Louisiana Tech
with a 1-point lead.
He's to the 40. Makes it out to about the 50.
Nothing tentative on that run at all. He looked very determined and got the first down.
Makes the handoff, and he's in trouble. Oh, he had a shot at the pick.
This is a very well-coached defense. They know to get their hands up in the air and to try to knock down passes.
From midfield, second down. They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a 5-wide outlook. He scrambled, and they got him.
I think that one's on the offensive line. They've got to do a better job of holding their blocks, or else this quarterback's going to be pulling turf out of his face mask all game.
And they'll probably try to throw here. They line up on third down and 14. Looks middle, got his back. And he hits him hard at the 47-yard line. Richardson is waiting for the snap. Tackle at the 16.
Every single time this offense has the ball, they're moving the football, but they're settling for field goals. And every time they settle for field goals, I've been watching the defense that they've been facing and watching how they run off the field to celebrate a job well done because they're not giving up touchdowns. That's a bad sign.
Fires incomplete.
These guys, especially in the secondary, really get after it and can make life hard for the play callers on the other side of the ball.
From their own 16-yard line, it's second down. They come out in a 5-wide set. Pulls it in, and he's in the open field. Tries to buy some time, and he has it on the corner. He gets hit out of bounds at the 29. And they're going to put 6 DBs on the field to counter that 5 receiver look.
Back line, three, three,
from their own 29-yard line. Second down. Got a man. Watch out here. Green here, and the halfback's got it. Tackle at the 36-yard line.
Gain of 1 yard. That brings up fourth and three.
Hall awaits the snap. Looking for the corner, and down he goes at the 46. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Louisiana Tech is up one. He makes it out to maybe the 49-yard line. He takes the option pitch and gets 2, maybe 3 yards. Second and 6 coming up here. Ball on the 49-yard line. Throws it in a hurry. And down he goes at the 32-yard line.
Turner makes the tackle at the 32-yard line. That makes it first and 10.
Mike, number 53.
He throws it. Makes the grab and steps out right away.
First down.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 13-yard line. And he is drilled at the 9. That little play action good for about 4 yards. The Bulldogs use their second timeout. Run there as they work the outside.
That's good for a gain of 5 yards. That'll make it 3rd and 1.
Let's go, let's go. Mike 53.
Quick throw, incomplete. One of his receiver.
Robinson says the intention to receive it.
This one should be makeable. Kicks up, and he got it.
Even though they gave up a field goal here, that defense is feeling pretty good about themselves right now. It could have just as easily been a touchdown.
Garrison looks ready to kick this one off.
Number 86 to return.
He's to the 20. He gets out to about the 25-yard line. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions.
56, Mike, 56. Green, no.
Makes the catch, and look out. He's to the 40. And that tackle very well could have saved the touchdown.
For a safety, this guy has really good hands. I'm very surprised to see him drop an interception like that. Could come back to haunt his team as well.
From the 38-yard line, second down. Scrambling around. He takes off. Decides to slide.
What is going on with this defense? I mean, don't get me wrong. The offense is doing a nice job with first downs, and they're executing well. But the defense is just letting them maintain possession and move the ball right down the field. They've got to try to change things up with their scheme. Be more aggressive. Attack. Do some things to change it up. Take some risks.
Marshall's going to have to use their second time out of the hat. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 12-yard line. He's tackled at the 3-yard line.
Easy, easy. Flair.
Got his receiver. Touchdown. So the kicker will line up here and try to give his team a three-point lead with this extra point. He makes the PAT. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Deloach fields it at the 2. There's a fumble. Picks up the fumble. And he's finally brought down at the 18-yard line. Poole's reputation really precedes him when you talk about how he can lead a team, but when you see him in person, you really feel it, Kirk.
It's a different, completely different feel when you watch him in person, and it has a lot to do with the intangibles that he brings to the table. I mean, there's examples here in his first half where he's been able to help his team, not just being able to throw the football or make good decisions, but just helping guys get back into the huddle, kind of patting guys on the back, trying to get this offense to believe in themselves, and almost just willing this team to a victory. And so far, he's done all those things.
The ruling on the field is reversed.
So the booth and the referee agree. The runner's knee was down.
That was still a close call, though, Brad. Even though he was down, this guy has to do a better job of holding that football.
Steps out of bounds at the 24. From their own 24-yard line, it's second down. And they make the stop at the 25-yard line. Played a half. Marshall leads 13-10.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 halftime show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollack here, completely locked in on that first half. So far, so good for both offenses in terms of taking care of the football, but now the defenses are ramping up the sense of urgency in terms of trying to get the ball back to their offense.
Absolutely. You got to find Reese. These ball hawks on defense, they need to find the football. They need to make some big plays, create some turnovers. How about using that hit stick a little bit? How about knocking somebody silly and making them drop the football? I mean, defense's number one priority is trying to turn the football over, try to make a big explosive play for your offense so they can do more damage and they can take the ball down the field. So those ball hawks need to show themselves in the second half.
David and I will be keeping an eye on your game and everything else going on in the country here in our palatial and comfortable surroundings in the studio. The best seat in the house belongs to Brad Nessler and Kirk Herbstreit.
Welcome back, everybody. Second half action about to begin. He's to the 20. He makes it to the 25-yard line.
I love the competitive spirit that we're seeing out on this field today. It looks like one team has the upper hand, and then the other comes right back in to be able to regain the lead. It's going to be an exciting finish.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. Hit as he threw, and he completes it. Brought down at the 32.
That'll bring up second and three.
Setting up play action. They'll bring him down at the 40-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 8 yards.
First down.
And he's taken down right around the 38-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
Runs right for a nice gain.
Good for a gain of 6 yards. That'll bring up second and three.
Let's go. We've got Mike, number 53.
Gets out to about the 22-yard line.
That brings him second and nine.
From the 22-yard line, second down. Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun. Five wide receivers. Gains his way to the 13-yard line.
More plays like this, and the coaching staff is going to need to change up the blocking schemes. You can't allow the defense to play in your backfield.
So the field goal unit is on the field. They'll try for 3 points. Louisiana Tech can tie it up here with this kick. The kick is up, and he's got it. Like they're ready for the kickoff. From his own goal line, he makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line. I think it says something about the quality of the preparation of both teams that we're into the third quarter and nobody's been able to pull away. Both sides seem to know what to expect. Down to around the 32. It's third down, and this offense is about 3 feet away from that first down marker. Here's an opening. He's taken down at the 44. Makes a catch, and he's got nowhere to go. He's going to try and scramble. Looks like he's going to run. He dives, and he'll be marked down. He's scrambling.
keeps it.
Slides down. And he can't make the grab.
Miller was the intended receiver on the play.
And this play is number 8 on the drive.
Hey, we gotta get the stop here, D. Mike 56, Mike 56.
Go! Runs outside for a nice game. So with that run, they pick up another first.
Just a nice job again up front by the offensive line. They're doing a good job of neutralizing the defensive front, and it's allowed them to move the ball down the field.
And he's tackled at the 28.
No gain on the play. That makes it 7 and 10.
Quick strike, and he drops it.
Shelton is the intended receiver on the play.
And this is the 11th play of the current drive.
Check 93 to Mike. 93 to Mike.
Wants to throw outside. Finds his receiver. Touchdown.
White out here truly knows what he has to do to contribute to make his team successful.
And he tacks on the extra point.
It was an 11-play, 77-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
So the score now, 20-13. Tackle at the 30.
Marshall's coaches just got to be happy. I'd love to coach a kid like this.
Oh, I think these coaches love to coach a guy like this, and another great performance by him individually and for this offense.
There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing.
Run, right side. Nice run there.
That's good for a game of 3 yards. That makes it 7-6.
And that Mike, number 53, Mike 53.
And he's tackled after positive yardage.
That's a genius.
Gets it out to about the 47-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
Gets to about the 47-yard line. And folks, it's neck and neck as we head to the final quarter of play. 20-13, Thundering Herd. Around the 40-yard line. Has some daylight. Gains his way to the 26-yard line. Taken down behind the line.
Let's go.
screen here, and the halfback's got it. And down he goes at the 30-yard line. This is the ninth play of this drive. This one's going deep to the end zone. Missed it. It's fourth down, and the offense is getting set to go for it. Quickly, and he's got his man. He's tackled at the 14-yard line. A little toss across the middle, and he is drilled at the 4-yard line.
McKinney on the tackle at the 4-yard line. That'll make it second and inches.
Touchdown, Bulldogs. We'll be tied with the extra point. And he hits the PAT. A 12-play, 69-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
Down the sideline. Room around the corner. Inside the 30. The 10. Touchdown, Thundering Herd. What a big-time return for that young man. Converts the extra point. Oh, has the ball set, and he looks ready to kick this one deep. He'll return it from the three. Brought down at the 30.
Boy, the two offensive coordinators have to be loving this. In fact, you can look over at our booth next to us and see how much they're enjoying it with a big smile on their face. The defensive coordinators, on the other hand, might be looking for a pink slip on Monday.
This is a pretty crucial series right here. With things being so tight, your best players have to step it up on both sides of the ball. They come out in an empty backfield. Now he tries to buy some time, and they bring him down for a sack on the play. So it'll be second and 14 after the setback. They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a five wide outlook. Got his receiver, dropped it, incomplete.
Not a great throw by the quarterback, but to be fair, that was pretty good coverage.
Less than 3 minutes in the game. Fourth down.
Nice defense. That was picture perfect. Three and out. Good series for these guys.
Richardson is the punter. Ferguson fields it at the 37, and down he goes at the 41-yard line. Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ballgame. He scrambled. Now he's going to run, and watch out. And he dives forward.
Five, 56,
takes the PAT. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Porter fields it at the two. He's tackled at the 29-yard line. They couldn't get anything going on that last drive. A little more than 2 minutes to go in the fourth quarter. Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry, and he hits him hard at the 38. So they pick up quite a few yards on that play, Kirk.
Well, that was an excellent route, and he did a great job of holding on to the football.
Set up a little screen, gets it to his tailback, and they make the stop at the 45-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
Going deep, lays it out there, and he's hit before it can go anywhere. And he's got it.
That's just a great call by the coordinator there, going to the air on first down.
Throws complete. He's got room to work. Run down at about the 11.
Ferguson's at the tackle at the 11-yard line. That brings him second and 5.
Huge play, and it's going to be first and goal.
McKinney brings him down at the 3-yard line. That makes it first and goal.
Two-score game, and they can cut that down here if they can get this one in the end zone. Five wide. Zips it to his receiver. Touchdown. Big, big touchdown through the air. And now it's a one-score game. And he adds the extra point. Marshall's dreams are a reality in this football game. They've scored 21 points in a row. The offense was able to punch it in the end zone on that last drive. They'll come back out looking for more of the same.
Great passing was the key for the offense the last time they had the ball. They were able to pick apart the defense and get down the field for a touchdown.
Good open field tackle. A gain of a yard on the quarterback keeper.
Solid stop there by the corner on that one. I'll tell you, I love to see a cornerback willing to step up and make tackles like that.
Just over a minute left. He's at the 30. It'll bring him down right around the 22-yard line.
That's a nice job by the quarterback to pitch the ball, and it got him a first down.
From the 22-yard line, first down. He's into the open field. And he's taken down around the 8-yard line.
Good solid running right there. Getting past the defensive lineman and into the secondary before he could be stopped.
And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. And he'll just take a knee here to kill the clock. From the 10-yard line, second down.
Watch two, watch two. Here we go. Green, down.
They'll knock him down for a loss.
Loss is 1 yard on the play. That makes it 3rd and goal.
Great game here today in a tight one, 34-27, Marshall. As we take a look at the highlights, Kirk, how would you summarize the action in this one?
Oh, this was a great football game, and these kids will remember this game for a long time.
Louisiana Tech played a great game out there, but I think they were a little bit outmanned. They're a good team, though. They'll bounce back from this.
For the Thundering Herd, they just keep winning in what has been a great year for them. And for Louisiana Tech, they go to 7-6 on what has been an average season.